Toledo native and nationally recognized sports journalist Christine Brennan back in her hometown earlier this week. Brennan, the USA Today columnist, currently serves as the University of Toledo's national board member and was on campus for the student athlete networking event. And she took time to sit down with our Danny Rogers to reflect on her career. In part two of that conversation, the award-winning journalist gives us the secret to success.
Well, the secret to success is that there is absolutely no secret to success. And what worked in 1950 and 1980 and 2010 will probably hopefully work in 2040. And that is, be willing to work harder than anybody else and come in on the weekends, or if your weekend is in sports working, then come in on Tuesday or Wednesday and just, you know, spend a couple hours in the office, be willing to do the extra thing. Of course, take days off now and then, of course. I'm not against days off or vacations, but show that while you're young, while you're there, I'm here. What can I do today? And I can come in tomorrow. And when they tell you, scram, kid, well, then you know you've probably done just enough, and it's time to go take a day off. Mm-hmm. And volunteer for new things. And, you know, ask, find mentors, and ask them to critique your work. Stay in touch with them, whether it's someone where you work, when it's you or anyone else we're talking about, or if it's someone that's just they met along the way in college, a professor in college, they can go back to and say, hey, would you read this or look at this or see, look at my reel or look at what I just did. To have mentors and to be in touch with them, because you never know when that mentor is going to mention it to someone else and then there's a job opening somewhere. You know, it's interesting when I mentioned hard work. I am not the greatest writer who ever lived. And I'm not the greatest reporter who ever lived, but I was willing to work harder than everybody else. And so talent is great, but if you said to me, you can have all the talent in the world or all the work ethic in the world, I would take all the work ethic.
You did mention it, you don't know what you would tell your 22-year-old self, yeah, looking back, but imagine I assume you're scrambling, you're looking for a job. How are you going to handle getting into this male-dominated world? What do you think you would tell your 22-year-old self at that time?
I think I would say to my younger self, you have no idea what's about to happen. It's going to be great. You're going to love it. And my younger self might, in one level, be kind of like, what? But I also think maybe she would have said, yeah, you know, I have a feeling good stuff's going to happen. Because I've been very optimistic, very positive, always. My mom and dad were that way, my siblings, the way we were raised. And just hard work would take you places and success would be yours. And I had that in high school sports and high school academics, college academics, and even intramural sports. Everything seemed to work out okay. So I guess I probably would have thought things would work out okay. But I will remember, I can totally picture where I was pulling that all night or writing those letters. And kind of going, oh my gosh, here's another letter I'm typing up again. And I like, how's this going to end? How's this story going to end? And I think I could not tap on that 22-year-old shoulder and say, it's going to end pretty well. Yeah.